Well, Paul Catalonotto came to a meet. We're at the Rotary Club meeting at Mike's Catfish, where he just gave a presentation on his local filmmaking. Lots to talk about there. But first, I want to get to the headline story. You're on PBS.
Yes, I'm on the PBS Online Film Festival with one of my films called Mr. United States. I am extremely happy to be in this festival. It's a very selective film festival. It is hard to get into, to say the least. They take 25 of the best films submitted from all across the country. They go online in a voting competition. It's like the Hunger Games of movies, right? It's placed out there and people vote on their favorite movie, and the winner gets the audience award, whoever gets the most votes.
So we're now able to vote?
You're now able to vote. There are three ways to vote. You can vote on the PBS Online Film Festival website for Mr. United States. You can vote on their YouTube page, and soon you'll be able to vote on Facebook.
When is the voting going on?
It started yesterday. It goes all the way till next Friday.
So we have a few days to vote.
You have a few days. And the great thing is on the PBS website, their website, you can vote as many times as you want, or you can vote every day, I should say.
So how do you vote for Paul Catalonotto, or is that the way it's listed?
It's Mr. United States, and you find that film in a mix of 25 and vote.
Well, what's the name of the film?
Mr. United States.
That you made?
That I directed. One of the things, too, is later on, I think we'll be able to share it to our Facebook page to make it a little easier for people to find.
So what was it about?
The Mr. United States is about Avery D. Wilson. He's a Baton Rouge native. He's the first person to win the Mr. United States crown. And what that is it's a pageant like Miss America, Miss Universe. And the film uses that basically as a backdrop, because the story mainly focuses on his sexuality and the bullying that came from that, and how he overcame that to ultimately become Mr. United States.
How can you watch the film?
It is, like I said, on the PBS Online Film Festival page. It's also on their PBS Online YouTube, and it's going to be on Facebook soon.
Will it also be broadcast?
I don't know. I think the winner gets broadcasted, but I'm not sure about that.
So this is exciting that you would rise from the level starting in Independence, Louisiana, and going up to a worldwide audience.
It's always exciting, you know, and this is not the first time that I've had that opportunity. You know, Sacrilege, my film was released worldwide, and the one before that. But I have to tell you this, the PBS moniker, the PBS name is very prestigious. So that, you know, in terms of being a documentary filmmaker, really, I think, adds a lot of credibility to the work.
So you just recently did a documentary on the city of Hammond and the history of Hammond, and I bring that up because, first of all, it took you a couple of years. It is quite a production, and possibly one of the best films, if not the best, on local history.
I appreciate that. That one was a labor of love that I worked with Andrew Glasscock of Channel 17, as well as yourself, Ken. It was, you know, I was glad to have gotten the opportunity to tell that story. I mean, local history is kind of a passion of mine. Florida parishes, you just talked to Sam Hyde, Florida parishes has a great history, a long-standing history, and it was just a pleasure to tell that story. Yeah, it took 2 years just to align all that up, to tell that story, to write it, to get it together, but it's also led that I'm going to be doing one on the history of Livingston Parish. That's going to be coming up very soon. You'll be able to see that on Action News. You know, and I also get the opportunity to tell a lot of stories about local people, like Brooks Attune, which was a great story. Precious Souls, the one on the lady who takes care of hospice dogs. Had a problem with that one out, but...
Well, because it's a unique concept, and you showed that particular film here to the Rotary Club in Amead, a lady who helps dogs who are going to die soon and die with dignity and help them in every way she can. It's a very heartwarming film.
You know, and that's one of the reasons why I showed that particular piece. That one's actually my wife's favorite. She was the one who encouraged me to get involved with that particular film. But you know, not enough attention. She does not get enough credit for what she does. And I look for any opportunity to show that film or any of the films that I've done for TARC.
And where is she located?
She's in Hammond, Louisiana.
Well, it may sound self-serving, but one of the things that you're doing also is you can do documentaries, you can do short films, you can do commercials for businesses. And our experience on Facebook has been huge for that, as advertising.
Well, Ken, you know better than anybody the presence of Action News 17 is amazing. We're reaching millions of people, and then this Facebook page is connected to pretty much, it's the heartbeat of the Florida parishes, the voice of the Florida parishes. And you know, newspapers have years before, they've kind of gone obsolete, but they've been offered for years advertisement for people, different services. You know, not only are you telling the news, well, now we're gonna all of a sudden, we're gonna give businesses a chance to be seen, get in front of their audiences.
Well, one of the things you found in your documentary film work is that you can produce a documentary and it'll be shown different ways, but when you tie it in with 50,000 Facebook subscribers, and that's before it gets shared, I mean, literally it is true, you can reach millions that way.
And we have. Look at any of the documentaries that we've produced. It's amazing the reach that we've already gotten. You know, Brooke's documentary just last week, I think last I checked, was over 30,000 views. Keep in mind, 30,000 complete views. That is one thing that's amazing about the Action News audience, or maybe even the Florida Parish audience. They're willing to sit down and watch these things. You know, you look at any of the statistics on which kind of movies should go online, short and sweet. Yeah, I do short and sweet stories, I do short and sweet commercials, but what I've really found amazing is it's a documentary like Hammond, which is almost 40,000 views, is a 55-minute documentary that people have watched. They've sit down on their phone, watch the entire thing. You know, I've had teachers email me, say like, man, this should be shown to every student in the area so they know something about their local history. I've had people just email me saying like, man, this is amazing. I can't believe somebody did this. And this is because of what we're doing with Action News now, what we're trying to bring.
So how can a person contact you?
You can just contact me on Facebook or email me or call me. My business line is 985-351-1635. Call me and we can pitch a project or ask me to do a commercial or find me on Facebook. We ask Ken, ask anybody, and we'll get in touch and make a commercial or a documentary or sponsor a documentary. It's kind of an endless, it's endless what we can do for businesses and individuals and governments around here.